collection of cities from around the world with really unique and interesting architecture. Families and children will discover not only interesting cities and learning about those cities, but there is literally hundreds of thousands of Lego bricks in which they can build their own cities and put them on display for people to admire. You don't need a passport to visit the world's greatest cities. You just need a ticket to Brickman Cities at 5.
For over 30 years, Advance has provided expert nutrition for Australian pets. Our food is proudly produced locally in the Central Tablelands. That's why the happiest dog gets pets are right in your home.
Come say hi at the Pet Pavilion to speak with pet experts and join in on awesome giveaways. Then make your way to meet some awesome friends at the Advance Bark Park.
Get Claritine for 24-hour relief from symptoms triggered by over 200 allergens. No one covers more allergens, indoors or out. Feel the clarity with Claritine. Get children's Claritine for 24-hour relief from symptoms triggered by over 200 allergens. No one covers more allergens, indoors or out. Feel the clarity with Claritine.
Yeah. Well, Jake Smith, we welcome into the arena now our competitors for the prestigious F.L. Crane, a competition that pits the finest mares in the showground against each other, 14-2 to 15-2. A trophy steeped in history. A judge this year from the United Kingdom in Lorraine Homer. And if you're joining us on the live stream today, welcome to you. You'll have Sammy Smith providing you tidbits of information in the Prestige Racehorse Transport broadcast box, brought to us by John and Linda Holgate. They absolutely love the F.L. Crane Trophy and the Colonel A.V. Pope Cup, two of the pinnacle classes out here. We're looking for thoroughbred qualities today, at least a percentage in each of our mounts. Jeff Penza will be officiating alongside Lorraine Homer today. Two judges, one winner of this year's F.L. Crane Trophy. Well, if you've just joined us here in the Giant Stadium or on our live stream, with facts coming to us from the Prestige Racehorse Transport broadcast box, welcome to you, whether you're here on site or virtually online. We've just kicked off the F.L. Crane Perpetual Trophy, donated by the late Mr. F.L. Crane and first presented here back in 1952. Mr. Crane was a well-known polo player and he was a breeder of thoroughbreds in the heart of thoroughbred country, Jerry's Plains in the Hunter Valley. His aim in presenting this trophy all the way back in 1952 was to encourage the breeding of a better saddle horse and to give a prize to the very best mare on the showground. I can tell you how on the ground here, the riders are smiling, the sun is shining, the horse flesh is top notch, and they're on the circle now for our two judges, Lorraine Homer from the United Kingdom and the very well-known Mr. Jeff Penza. This was originally presented back in the day to the best mare or filly hack over 14-2, not exceeding 15 hands, and the height restrictions of been adapted over the years. It's currently awarded for the best mare or filly hack over 15 hands, showing a percentage of thoroughbred qualities. and, in the opinion of our judges, being suitable for the breeding of hacks.
Well, Lindsay Douglas, speaking of our two judges here this afternoon, we speak of Mr. Jeff Penza. Jeff's based in the Hawkesbury here in New South Wales. Actually, one of our leading provincial jockeys as we speak. Been a wonderful jockey for many, many years, riding the provincial circuit here in New South Wales at Kembla Grange, Newcastle, Canberra, Hawkesbury. And I actually just took a look at the fields for Canberra tomorrow, and he has a few rides at the Canberra meeting tomorrow. So, lovely to welcome Mr. Jeff Penza here this afternoon. And also Miss Lorraine Homer from the UK, with over 30 years' experience in judging. Lorraine has judged hunters, hacks, ponies and thoroughbreds. Lorraine herself owns hacks, hunters and thoroughbreds with such a passion for these breeds and a wealth of knowledge. So it's lovely to welcome here this afternoon Mr. Jeff Penza and Miss Lorraine Homer.
And we have some of our fine horse committee stewards here on the ground assisting in the royal standard of running for this class. A very special class indeed on the ground. We welcome Mr. Bill Picken, OAM, a long-serving member of the Sydney Royal Easter Show stewards team here.
Past ringmaster too, Lindsay Douglas.
Indeed, a man who knows how the FL Cray needs to be run. I just realised I'm on your big screen there. Good to see you all. We have Amy Eggleton down here, a beautiful rider herself from Golgol in New South Wales. I think she's turning into a nice brood mare as well. She's pregnant at the moment and a wonderful steward here, married to one of our chief stewards, Mr. Chris Eggleton, who's the son of the late, great Peter Eggleton and the grandson of Roger Wotton, who was involved in ringmaster duties during his tenure at Sydney Royal too. I have to tell you, it's so lovely. All the riders are smiling down here. It's just a glorious sight, the FL Crane Trophy. Melissa Ozu from Walgett, successful the other day in our judges and stewards class, has won it on a previous occasion. And Michelle Brennan, who is a big part of the South Coast show movement, particularly Kiama Show. And if there's a prettier showground in all of Australia, I haven't seen it. But we are enjoying this class here. But there's plenty going on around the grounds, not just the FL Crane Trophy. Mr. Jake Smith.
Certainly is, Lindsay Douglas, to bring you up to date with our current classes that are being judged here in the Giants Main Arena here this afternoon in ring number two. We are judging class number 38. And then we welcome our Arabian Derivative exhibitors into the arena here this afternoon. And the first class to go is class number 38. The Arabian Derivative mare or filly, 3 years and over 15 hands. We welcome our judge, Miss Carolyn Potts from South Australia, judging our Arabian Derivatives here this year. Also our chief steward in charge, Councillor Mr. Duncan McIntyre from Scone. Lovely to see you, Duncan. And our stewards, Mr. Ken Cameron, Miss Sharon Hugh-Smith and Miss Michelle Brennan. In front of the members stand here this afternoon, in ring number three, we're judging class number 184, the Australian Saddle Pony Mare or Gelding, over 13.2 hands and not exceeding 14.2 hands. We welcome our judge, Miss Rhonda Bromley from Parks here in New South Wales, our chief steward in charge, Councillor Mr. Chris Carter, our stewards, Miss Jeanette Dowse and Miss Robin Rogers. And in ring number four, in front of the Sinclair and Martin and Enger stands, we are now judging class number 610, our working hunters. Small ponies working here this morning. Now we have our working hunter measuring over 15 hands in height. Well, courses have set here this afternoon as our working hunters will jump the fences and the maximum height of our fences is up to 80 centimetres in height. So we're welcome down to ring number four, our judge, Miss Alice Homer from the UK. We're chief steward here this afternoon, Miss Councillor Miss Denise Ovens, and our stewards, Mr. Dick Adams, Miss Jodie Spresser, Miss Leanne Martin, and also to our show jumping team, Mr. Tim Danzy, Mr. Simon Barry, also down there this afternoon. So a very good afternoon and welcome. And Lindsay Douglas, we've got the glorious sunshine here this afternoon as well.
We sure do. Jake Smith, indulge me for a moment as I take you on a bit of a tour of the history of this class dating back to 1952. So they're all walking on the circle, I should say, at the moment. And our judges, Lorraine Homer and Jeff Penza, will start to nominate their lineup and ask them to get in line for their individual workouts. But back in 1952, in the inaugural year of the F.L. Crane Perpetual Trophy, we had medley exhibited here by the Smith family, who came back in 1953 and was once again awarded the prestigious silver-plated wine cooler. It is a beautiful piece of silverware too. In 1954, Mrs. R.M. Emery exhibited Sky Gold to success, followed by the Swadley family's nomination of Vanity, who took it out in both 1955 and 1956. The Dickey and Perry families exhibited Clan, taking out the win in 1957. It was Gem with the Clark and King families in 1958 that was successful. Sky Gold for Mrs. R.M. Emery returned in 1959 and took the win, some 6 years after its initial success in 1954. The Tweedles exhibited Lady Sabrina in 1960 and were winners, and the McIntyres exhibited Drift in 61 and 62 to take the trophy out. But here we are with our first of our exhibitors to work out. On the live stream, you'll be getting some information from Sammy Smith, brought to us by the Prestige Livestock Bloodstock Transport team in the Hawkesbury. John and Linda Holgate, their fleet of 11 luxurious vehicles. Their wonderful son, Daniel, builds a number of them. Helen's great in administration. And the gorgeous grandkids too, Nicholas and Mia. A big part of the family operation that is Prestige Racehorse Transport, based in the Hawkesbury. Well, we can see the first of our competitors being shown the workout now. And I can tell you that this will be catalogue number 1894, South Australian exhibit.
Well, to all of our lovely viewers at home, I have the privilege of telling you a little bit about this horse that is first off in the prestigious event known as the Cole A.V. Pope competition. Apologies, ladies and gentlemen, that is actually the F.L. Crane we are starting with. Catalogue number 1894 is known as Lyndon Park Touch the Golds. The lovely jockey aboard is Briny. This horse was in fact sired by War Chant, a USA stallion, and a dam that goes by the name of Sky drama. This horse is owned by Alexia Fraser, and as we can see, it is a stunning bay mare. She has been quite successful in recent times at a few shows, most recent of which in 2023 at Grand Nationals. They happened to take out the small saddle horse over 15 hands and not exceeding 16 hands. And Bryony Randall happened to be aboard at this time as well.
Well, as we see the first of our workouts here in the prestigious FL Crane Trophy. I've been taking on a bit of a history tour of previous successful exhibitors. The Angus and Cameron families brought water level here in 1963 to claim the trophy. The Mulligan family had personality successful in 1964. In 1965, it was the Throsbys with Parody. In 66, the Kentwalls were with Belle Fleur. The Miller and Croft combination in 67 were successful with Liz, who also took out the trophy in 68. And then for three consecutive years, it was Princess Buchanan with Miss Baker and Miss Hockey, who were victorious here in the FL Crane Perpetual Trophy class. Well, that's the workout there for 1894, a nice cheer from the crowd. 1902, a Victorian nomination now, into the ring.
Well, we have our first results coming back here in the afternoon program from ring number two. This is for class number 38, our Arabian derivative mare, or filly, 3 years and over 15 hands. Our winner here this afternoon is breastplate number 1031, Sable Farm and Future Farms from Romsey in Victoria, and EBL Impress. Congratulations. Our second place ribbon, catalogue number 1029, Mrs. Amy Dildes from Grosvale here in New South Wales. And the beautiful nomination, Crack-a-Lackin. Our third place ribbon, breastplate number 1028, Miss Georgie Batten. And ML Aber Shalow. Our fourth place ribbon, three places in that particular class. So congratulations there to our first, second and third place getter. Class number 38, the Arabian derivative mare or filly, 3 years and over 15 hands.
Well, Jake Smith, thank you for the results from our other rings. Back to our FL Crane. We have the lovely Ali Burke and Mr. Greg Geary's nomination in Coronation. She is a lovely bay mare, sired by Cranford Cliffs, and the dam, of course, was Bella Bianco. Before her time here in the Hack Ring, she was amongst one of our wonderful former racehorses in this event and went by the name of Lady Dween. She had 25 starts for no first places, but she did pick up a second and two thirds, with a total race earning of a little over $20,000. And she only retired in February 2021.
We welcome the third of our competitors to work out now in the FL Crane Perpetual Trophy. It's catalogue 1119.
Lovely welcome out to our Giants Main Arena also here this afternoon, our green coats. Lovely to welcome Mr. Cliff Parker, Mr. Tom Steger. Nice to see you this afternoon, Tom. Mr. Mike Rowland, Mr. Stephen Myhill, Mr. Scott Jones Ryan, and Mr. Ben Collette. Welcome, gentlemen. And also a very good afternoon and welcome to our ringmaster, Councillor Mr. James Angus.
Well, the stunning grey horse that we are seeing go around the ring at the moment, exhibit 119, brought to us by Miss Mary Holman, goes by the name of Private Valentine. She's a grey mare at 11 years old. Also one of our lovely former racers who have found quite a loving home by the looks of things here in the show ring. Private Valentine raced 23 times for one first, 4 seconds, and a third. In her time as a racehorse, she totaled an earning of $21,945. And of course, this mare is also owned by Mary Holman.
It's great to welcome Carolyn Searcy here on the grounds, capturing all of the action. Of course, a very much loved race day presenter and the executive producer of Thoroughbreds, the great televised national breeding program. Hosted Sky Racing for many years and the great program, Bred to Win on Foxtel, is Carolyn's doing. Great to have Carolyn back here on the ground. Well, we look back through the annals of history, and in 1972, this gorgeous trophy went to Fascination with the Hunter and Delamont families. Mrs. Mobley took it out in 1973 with Nanel, and we just saw the work out there of catalogue number 1119. Believe this next exhibit to work out will be 1126. In 1974, the F.L. Crane Perpetual Trophy was handed to Max Gift with the McNee family. Nanel returned in 1975, having taken out in 73 to win it once again. Kahlua with the Seller Jones family was successful in 1976. Miss J. Bradford was the recipient of the trophy in 1977 with Justella. Well, we'll head on now to the Prestige Racehorse Transport broadcast box on the live stream for details on our next mare to work out in the FL Crane Trophy.
Well, Lindsay Douglas, thank you for that introduction. The next competitor in the ring is catalogue number 1126. Exhibited by Mrs. Diane Phillips in Labella. Labella is a lovely bay mare, who is also approximately 11 years old. She was sired by Congrats. And in her time as a racehorse, she also ran under the name Bella Skura. She didn't happen to make it to any races, simply only trialing, but once again has found quite an adoring home and a few adoring fans here on the grounds. Ladies and gentlemen, that is catalogue number 1126, exhibited by Miss Diane Phillips.
If you've just joined us here in the Giant Stadium, we're enjoying the FL Crane Perpetual Trophy, enormously prestigious class for mares, exhibiting a percentage of thoroughbred qualities. Two highly qualified judges in the ring, one from the United Kingdom in Lorraine Homer, and one from the racetrack, Jeff Penza. Great to have Jeff's knowledge here of the thoroughbred industry. We've been looking back through previous winners, and in 1978 and 79, the Prattley family were successful with Trinity. They were pipped to the post the following year in 80 when Kalua once again returned to take out the trophy, having won it in 1976. In 81, Trinity returned to be successful once again. A great celebration of mares that have, in some instances, had successful progeny or been successful themselves on the racetrack, others that weren't so, but lovely thoroughbred types nonetheless. We've just seen the workout for 1126, and now we welcome out another lovely grey in 1121.
Well, Lindsay Douglas, we have yet another racehorse here, formerly in Set in Diamonds, who of course is brought to us by Miss Courtney Larrard and Mrs. Tony Ambrose. She is a grey mare at approximately 13 years old, owned by Tony herself, but once again, she ran under a bit of a different name in her racing career of Buzzy Bee. She raced twice for no success, but did manage to go home with a $200 prize money nonetheless. She is quite the stunning mare who has been rather successful on the show ring, I believe, as well, Lindsay. Well, ladies and gentlemen, as I was saying, this lovely horse we're seeing work out right now in exhibit 1121, Set in Diamonds, quite successful in the world of hacking. And it was only last week that she was out at the 2023 Grand National Competition. She was seen not only in the child saddle horse over 15 hands, ridden by an under 17-year-old rider. She was also in the small saddle horse over 15 hands, not exceeding 16 hands. And she was also exhibited in the rider class of 30 years and over. So quite a successful life post maybe a not so successful racing career.
Well, the beautiful trophy that we see here is brought to us by the Inglis family and huge history. Widely involved in livestock, horses, the sale of land. Big broodmare sale coming up shortly. The Easter sale just completed. Very successful indeed. But a history dating back to 1867 as a company. Founded on the principles of honesty and integrity, and still demonstrating those today, regarded highly in the bloodstock industry worldwide. We thank the Inglis family and the Inglis company for their support of the F.L. Crane trophy and look forward to seeing the presentation. Well, we just saw the workout mere moments ago of catalogue 1121, but now this is catalogue 1872.
Well, we can also see Lindsay Douglas in front of the member stand here this afternoon. Ring number three, we are judging our first class here this afternoon, the Australian Saddle Pony Mare. Well, Gelding over 13 two hands and not exceeding 14 two hands. It's the Australian Saddle Pony Association celebrating 50 years this year. They were established in 1973. The registered Australian saddle ponies may vary in height between 11 and 14 two hands, colouring ranging from black, grey, brown through to palomino, buckskin, peluche, and pinto colorations. The wonderful Australian saddle pony should be refined quality, short in length, displaying intelligence and character with alert, active, well-proportioned ears placed close together over a broad forehead. In the neck should be long, sweeping upwards in a graceful, elegant appearance, light-muscled and slightly crested for the stallions. The shoulders should be long and sloping. Their back should be short and well-muscled, and the loins short and strongly coupled. That's a little bit of a background on our Australian saddle ponies, and we are judging class number 184, the Australian saddle pony mare, or gelding, over 13 two hands and not exceeding 14 two hands.
Back to our FL crane class. We have just watched a lovely black exhibit go through in 7072, my apologies, with Tina Johnstone aboard and Mr. Riley Kent. Of course, this horse was La Dolce Vita, sired by Bianconi, I believe. Bianconi, my apologies. The owner, of course, is Gilly Johnson, who lives over in the UK.
Well, the next to work out is catalogue number 1750 here in the FL Crane. Best mare or filly class over 15 hands. They must be suitable for the breeding of hacks in the eyes of our two judges. So show hunters not eligible in this class. And the entries in this class must be registered as a thoroughbred with a thoroughbred stud book. We are looking for lovely thoroughbred qualities here, so it's very fitting that Mr. Jeff Penza is on the judging panel.
Well, thank you, Lindsay. This lovely pony, ladies and gentlemen, that we are seeing go around this workout is, of course, DP Giselle. Miss Louise Ruffalo is the owner, and this horse actually managed to win here last year. And I'll tell you what, her race name of She's Amazing is quite fitting. Not only did she win here last year, she also has a couple of race wins under her belt and a few other placings with a total earning of $31,825 under her belt there as well.
Well, we have our presentation taking place in ring number 3 in front of our members stand here this afternoon. We have a beautiful lineup of our Australian saddle pony, Meryl Gelding, over 13 two hands and not exceeding 14 two hands, class number 184. And our winner here this afternoon is catalogue number 1436, Miss Zali Cameron. Congratulations, Zali, from Wattle Flat here in New South Wales. And Lingtree, 5-star. Our second place ribbon goes to breastplate number 1439, Johnson & Johnson, McNeil and the Castle families from Dubbo here in central west New South Wales, and they are having a wonderful show and their beautiful nomination, Rosemont Ace of Hearts. Third place, catalogue number 1066, it's a Welsh family, Kay, Taryn and Alicia Welsh from Glenorie here in New South Wales, and Tremaine Let's Dance. Our fourth place ribbon, catalogue number 1073, Alexandra Buster Jones in Spotlight. Fifth place will be awarded to catalogue number 1438, Mrs. Kylie Hodge, in Pogram Park, Virtuous. Our sixth place ribbon, catalogue number 1435, Miss Molly Best from Ralston and Miranda Fortitude. And our seventh place ribbon, congratulations, catalogue number 1441, Miss Jessica Waite from Thelmere in Fairwood Masterpiece. Congratulations, a beautiful lineup.
We've just seen the workout a moment ago of 1750 here in the FL Crane Perpetual Trophy. And working out now is catalogue 1128. Well, Sammy Smith is bringing us all of the insights on the live stream up there in the Prestige Racehorse Transport broadcast box, sponsored today by John and Linda Holgate. They're the people we trust to move our horse flesh, whether it's worth several million dollars on the racetrack or just millions of dollars in our hearts. They move ponies, Galloway, show hunters, all sorts of breeds of horses and tons of thoroughbreds. They've been synonymous with getting horses from A to B to the likes of the Caulfield Cup, the Melbourne Cup, Magic Millions each year. They're ensuring that the freshly purchased yearlings are going to the right places afterwards and safely delivered there. The great team at Prestige Racehorse Transport, Daniel, Helen and the grandkids too, Nicholas and Mia, thanks so much for your support of our broadcast box today.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, once again, this is catalogue number 1128. This lovely exhibit is brought to us by Miss Michaela Scott, a horse she calls Ruby Rose, a black mare foaled in 2008, of course, to the wonderful sire in Dane Shadow. He himself was exhibited by Hobartville Stud and had a little over $200,000 to his race career. But back to Ruby Rose, who actually raced under the name Diamond Springs, had 24 starts for $29,325 in her racing career.
Well, that was the workout there for 1128. Catalogue 1749 will work out next in the FL Crane Trophy.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, this lovely exhibit in 1749 is brought to us by Harrison Rainey, a horse that they call GG Flirtatious, sired by Tickets, and is actually owned by Harrison himself. This horse actually had a racing career of its own, however, unlike Tickets, wasn't all that successful. Had five starts for no placings, but did take home the $600 that they do get for running in a race.
Well, we can see ring number four in front of our Martin and Inga stand and our Sinclair stand. We have class number 610 currently being judged as we speak, which is the working hunter over 15 hands. See, our working hunters have put over a course of fences also here this afternoon. The balance and looking for that true hunter type. Judge from the UK, Miss Alice Homer, judging our working hunters here this afternoon. They're measuring over 15 hands. The height of our fences are up to 80 centimetres in height. And we can see now our exhibitors are coming forward, and we will make the presentation very, very shortly.
Well, we've just seen the work out there from catalogue 1749. We'll head on now to the black mare that's just stepped out in front. It's 1910 in your books.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, 1910 is an exhibit that goes by the name of Heiress and brought to us by Miss Samantha Watt. This, of course, is not the horse that she would normally have here today. Sadly, she lost her wonderful pony in Emirati just at the start of May. And only 3 weeks later did she find her way into her lovely exhibit she's here with today, Heiress. She, of course, has been quite successful in order to qualify here this weekend, and actually only competed last week over at SIAC in Grand Nationals in the small saddle horse, over 15 hands and not exceeding 16 hands high.
Well, as we can see here this afternoon in front of the Sinclair stand, we are calling forward now our winner and place getters of class number 610, Working Hunter, over 15 hands. The winner here this afternoon is catalogue number 2065, Miss Melissa Gillies from here in Sydney. Congratulations, Melissa, for having a wonderful show. And that's Verdict by Direction is the horse that she is riding. Our second place ribbon, catalogue number 2043, Miss Tia Thomas from the wonderful sheep and cattle country of Coola here in central west New South Wales, not far from Dunedoo and Mudgee and Brynong, Arizona. Our third place ribbon, catalogue number 2037, Miss Millie Graham from Denman, in the heart of our thoroughbred breeding industry, and Coolrusta Divine Ocean. Our fourth place ribbon has gone to catalogue number 2052, Master Harrison Wessel from Victoria and Kelturn Flash. Our fifth place ribbon, catalogue number 2053, Miss Marilyn Anderson from Glenvale in Queensland. Lovely to see you here this year, Marilyn, and Windora. Congratulations, they are the results for class number 610, the Working Hunter, over 15 hands.
Well, we've just seen the work out there for 1910 in the FL Crane. Congratulations to those lovely exhibits, Jake Smith, in front of the Sinclair stand. We're now going to head on to the workout of catalogue 1751.
Well, Lindsay Douglas, catalogue 1751, of course, is a horse that is called Bella Sinenka. She is brought to us by Miss Cherie Schiltz, who is also the owner of this lovely mare, who I believe is around 21 years old. She, of course, is sired by the wonderful horse in Congrats, a USA stallion with a fair few wins under his own belt. And, of course, Bella Sinenka was obviously bred to do the same. However, as a racing career, she didn't have too much success. 2 third places to a name and a total of $8,400 in her time as a racehorse.
Well, we've been doing a bit of a trip down history lane here with the FL Crane Perpetual Trophy, dated back to 1952. And I've been taking you all the way through to 1982 when Bankisha with the Horsley family was successful. In 83, Burrendar Stud brought Burrendar Shashane here to success. In 84, it was Burrendar Babette with the Swift family. The Scholes and Sawyer family in 1985 with Occasion. followed by the Pets with Morena Penny Lane. In 87, it was the Bulmers' nomination of Osterly Marcel. Well, Barandar Babette came out 5 years after the initial win in 84 and took out the trophy in 88. Persian Gem was successful in 89 with the Boyce family. The Nelsons were successful in 1990 with Twist of Fate. In 91, it was Dale Plum's nomination of Lover. In 92, the Harding family's Symphony. In 93, the Greenwood's Avalon Park, Paris, followed by Pure Cast in 94, Jet Set in 95, Work of Art in 96, Cartier in 97. Well, Work of Art returned in 98 to reclaim the trophy before Sunset Charisma, GB Sunset Charisma in 99, and Instant Kite with KP Hood in 2000. Well, the workout now of one of our final competitors here in the FL Crane Best Mare or Filly Hat class. It's 1863, and we'll head on now to the live stream with Sammy Smith in the Prestige Racehorse Transport broadcast box.
Thank you, Lindsay Douglas. Exhibit number 1863 is a horse that goes by the name of Illuminate NZ. He is brought to us this weekend by the exhibitor Mitchell Fox. And of course, the sire of this lovely mare we're seeing work out now was Redwood. This horse itself is only approximately 5 years old and has had quite a successful career here in the Hacking Ring. This mare is actually owned by Jenny McDonald.
Well, going back 20 years ago, and Lost Lady was successful here in the FL Crane Trophy 3 years in a row with the Whelan family and G. Beck. In 2004, Heldon Park Classic with the Holgate and Christie combination took out the win. Willowcroft Regal Design was successful in 2005. In 2006, it was Willowcroft Regal Wish, followed by San Lira Just Glitter in 2007. Yo Way Lady in Red in 2008. Nottingham Fine Print with Pam Bush in 2009. Magnifique with Courtney Christie and Stephen Merry in 2010. We welcome out into the ring and catalogue number 1870.
Well, ladies and gentlemen watching at home, the lovely exhibit we're seeing now is catalogue number 1870, brought to us by Miss Alani Ware, a horse she calls Tierra. Of course, sired by the wonderful stallion in Shooting to Win. Shooting to Win, of course, is one of our Australian stallions who was chained under Peter and Paul Snowden. Based right here in Sydney Randwick, and quite a competitive racehorse in his own right.
Well, we welcome our next class in front of our Sydney Royal Stand. They're currently being judged as we speak now with our judge from South Australia, Miss Carolyn Potts. This is class number 37, the Arabian derivative mare or filly. Reuse an over 14 hands and not exceeding 15 hands. As Lindsay Douglas said earlier on here today, the broadcast box here today is proudly presented by Prestige Racehorse Transport. This Prestige have been operating since 2005. Their reputation is first class. Prestige Racehorse Transport offers a modern fleet and experienced drivers to ensure safe and secure relocation for your horses. For the most professional and experienced transport company around, Prestige Racehorse Transport should be your number one choice.
Well, we're looking back through history now, and in 2011, it was Angela Forrester's nomination of Silver Elegant that took out the FL Crane Trophy. Angela Forrester, followed by Shelley Penny's nomination of True Liberty in 2012. DP Ophelia was successful with Daisy Patch Start in 2013. Alkira Elegance and Belinda Scanlon in 2014. Belinda Dicker brought her nomination of Tevita in 2015 to take the trophy. Well, that's the last of our workouts there. Catalogue number 1870. LA Catwalk was our victor in 2016. Angela Javier. Debbie Garland with CP Glamour in 2017. Queen of Hearts RA in 2018 for Rachel Addison. Kathleen Mullins Divinity in 2019. Of course, no Sydney Royal Easter Show in 2020. It was the year for Royal Highness and Romsey Park with young Emily Murray from Victoria in 2021. And last year was the year for Louise Ruffalo and DP Jezel. Well, our judges, Lorraine Homer and Jeff Penza, are asking to see each of our exhibits once more on the circle, really paying close attention now to confirmation. I can see them diligently discussing each of our nominated exhibitors. And Jake Smith, for those in the crowd who have just joined us here in the Giant Stadium, we're watching the FL Crane Perpetual Trophy brought to us by Inglis. We're looking for our best mare or filly hack over 15 hands. They have to be registered as a thoroughbred. There's some interesting links with the racing world out here in the dam and sire of some of these lovely mares. Some of them have raced themselves, but qualified judges out here in the ring, Jake Smith.
Well, we certainly do. Lindsay Douglas, of course, as you said, one of our judges here this year, Mr. Jeff Penza. And Jeff is one of our leading provincial jockeys here on our provincial racetracks here on the Sydney Basin and also around the Hunter Valley region, riding at Scone and Musselbrook, Kembla Grange, Newcastle, had great success at Newcastle. He's actually booked for rides tomorrow at Canberra. It's a wonderful jockey, a wonderful horseman. It's lovely to welcome Mr. Jeff Penza from Hawkesbury here in New South Wales. And of course, we have Miss Lorraine Homer, who Lorraine is one of our international judges. She's from the UK and with over 30 years experience of judging hunters, hacks, ponies and thoroughbreds, which she specialises in. Lorraine herself owns hacks, hunters and thoroughbreds as well. So it's lovely to welcome to this year's Sydney Royal Easter Show Miss Lorraine Homer, and lovely to welcome one of our leading jockeys, Mr. Jeff Penza, also into the Giants Main Arena this afternoon.
Well, we have some absolute queens of the thoroughbred and showing world here down for the presentation in a moment of the F.L. Crane Perpetual Trophy. Carolyn Searcy, great to see you. I'm used to seeing you on a 2D screen.
It is a bit like that, isn't it? No, it's just wonderful seeing these gorgeous horses on these screens because they are outstanding. They're a really interesting range of pedigrees. We know that they're not all necessarily by champion size. You know, there are sort of, you know, Zazoos out there and Dane Shadows and Denons and Bien Conies and horses like that. So it's a really interesting thing to see, you know, the breeding racing world come together here with the show world.
Can you tell us where we might see some of this footage? Are we going to see it on Bred to Win? What are we going to see it on?
We will see some on Bred to Win Monday night. We'll show some of the winners of the Whitten Trophy, the Crane and the Pope. And then Thoroughbreds Ago, when that returns in May, we'll do a full feature story with some interviews about, you know, what the Royal Easter Show is trying to do, what the RAS are trying to do here in improving these classes and having more thoroughbreds actually going into equestrian homes.
One of my highlights today was seeing Hot King Prawn out here in a lead class, 7.3 million or something.
Yeah, quite incredible. And a couple of Hong Kong, former Hong Kong gallopers are here. Rebecca Brown of Hillview does a great job in bringing them over. Helene Charisma, you know, a few others she's brought back from Hong Kong or the owners have sent back, and she's put so much work into them. So really exciting to see, and seeing some other familiar names as well. I think Precedence is out here later in the day with Fee McIntyre as well. So, you know, it is again that bringing the racing, the whole world together with this world.
Well, Jake Smith has a result now from our ring, but Carolyn Searcy, a joy to see you out here.
Thank you for having me.
Well, thanks very much, Lindsay Douglas. We make the presentation in front of our Sydney Royal stand this afternoon, class number 37, our Arabian derivative mare or filly, 3 years and over. Over 14 hands and not exceeding 15 hands. And a big congratulations, breastplate number 1027. Sable Farm and Future Farms from Romsey in Victoria, and Rivoli Magic is the winning exhibitor here this afternoon. Congratulations, wonderful exhibitors, Sable Farm and Future Farms. Our second place ribbon, catalogue number 1025, EB Lodge Performance Horses from Whittingham here in New South Wales, and the Lambie Park Euphoria. Our third place ribbon, catalogue number 1024, Mrs. Jenna Jacqueline Carrington from Oakdale here in beautiful New South Wales, and Arabic Callisto. Congratulations, a beautiful class. And we are now presenting our winner and place getters for class 37 for your catalogue, our Arabian derivative mare or filly, 3 years and over 14 hands and not exceeding 15.
Well, the wonderful Inglis family name, William Inglis and Co., dating back some century and a half, synonymous with the sale of the finest bloodstock in Australia, bringing us the F.L. Crane Trophy. It's been a class that's been run here since 1952, and I'm going to try and catch Sabrina Durante. Sabrina, you're holding something quite significant in your hands.
Isn't it beautiful? It's made by David Calvert, and the colour says it all. It's our favourite colour, the Durantes. You can't go wrong with pink.
For those who don't know, this gorgeous young lady is not only an overly talented equestrian, but also a performer and a singer. And your mum and dad are really show ring royalty.
They are. Yeah, I grew up here, so I feel like I'm stepping into their shoes being here today, and I'm very thankful for them.
Kim and Simon Durante were judging here not so long ago.
Yeah, if they're not competing, then they're judging, so they've always got an involvement somehow.
Mum's had some wonderful successes. I think took out champion lady rider at every royal show in Australia 1 year.
I don't think she ever comes and doesn't get champion.
That's about right. And you'll never miss Kim Durant in a ring because she's always looking as magnificent as you look today. You'll be making this presentation today. And David Calbert, wonderful show competitor.
Thank you so much. Yeah, he truly is.
Well, we wait with bated breath. This great lineup of thoroughbred mares out here. As Carolyn Searcy said, there's some impressive pedigrees on display here today. Lorraine Homer and Jeff Penzer do not have an easy task in front of them now, but I can see our chief steward, Mr. Christopher Eggleton of Golgong, has received the official word, and moments from now, we will have a result.
So welcome out our next class in ring number three here this afternoon. This is class number 183 of Australian saddle pony mare, or gelding, over 12 two hands and not exceeding 13 two hands.
Well, we do hope you've enjoyed the live stream. Those of you joining us through the Prestige Racehorse Transport broadcast box, Sammy Smith doing a lovely job up there, one of our young interns from Coonabarabran, who is part of the Sydney Royal, the Land Ag Shows New South Wales Young Woman Competition last year, a finalist, and has returned this year to help with stewarding and producing in the broadcast. So thanks, Sammy, for jumping on the mic up there and sharing some of the details that we can't share in the live arena. Such as the breeding, the background, the racing successes and previous show wins of each of our lovely mares out here in the FL Crane Perpetual Trophy.
Well, Lindsay Douglas, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, I now have the result for the winner of the F.L. Crane Best Mare or Filly Hack over 15 hands. And it's with great pleasure we invite forward catalogue number 1894 BR Show Team from Pakenham in South Victoria, and Lyndon Park, Touch the Clouds. Congratulations.
Bryony Randall here, enormously talented campaigner on a mare that has had huge success. Alexia Fraser will be absolutely delighted with this outcome today. Well, the purple ribbon comes forward now with Jeff Penzer. The silverware dating back to 1952 in the hands of Lorraine Homer.
Well, of course, Lindsay Douglas, this particular mare was champion hack at Royal Melbourne last year in 2022. So reserve at the Show Horse Council of Victoria. And a lovely result here this afternoon from Lyndon Park, Touch the Clouds, sired by a United States sire in War Chant out of Sky Drama.
for the presentation now of the beautiful pink garland. And the gentleman behind all of this, Sabrina Durante.
David Calvert.
Loves his show horses.
It's very beautiful.
We invite forward now our reserve champion, catalogue number 1750, Miss Louise Ruffalo's nomination from Kenthurst here in New South Wales, and DP Giselle. Congratulations.
Last year's winner. Fantastic to be on the podium once again, DP Giselle. A stunning mare indeed. Louise, we'd love to get a couple of words from you. Congratulations once again.
Thank you. So good to be back up here. She's such a true mare. So beautiful ride all the time. And yeah, great to enjoy it.
Tell me about your relationship. How did you come across this mare?
We were blessed enough to get Macy off the Plums in Victoria. So Dale and Heidi, coming up to 3 years, and it's just been a dream ever since. She's a pleasure to have in the stables, forever tries our hardest, so it's really nice to have.
Well done to you, gorgeous Louise, taking out reserve champion this year with DP Giselle. Bryony Randall, a spectacular moment, and having a bit of fun out here with Linden Park, touched the clouds, and understandably so, she knows she's looking hot out there. Tell us a bit about this lovely horse.
I flew up last year to ride her for Alexia and the Crawford twins, and she was successful, and we'd hoped that she could win this event because I think she's the epitome of a Crane Trophy mare. I've been lucky enough to win it a couple of times, and I just thought if any horse I've ever ridden, this is a Crane mare. So I'm just so happy that we could win today for the owners, and I know Alexia will be super happy.
Well done to you, Bryony Randall. Put your hands together for Linden Park, Touch the Clouds, and DP Giselle, our reserve champion here in the FL Crane Perpetual Trophy, a new name etched into the silverware today. Well, I can see Lorraine Homer and Jeff Penzer having individual conversations with each of our mares out here. And I'm going to try and put a microphone in front of Lorraine. We'd love to hear your comments on this class, Lorraine.
Oh, it's really an interesting class, and we've just spent the whole time placing them down to seventh or eighth, so actually we didn't have such a difficult task as we made it. But the winner just shone from the moment she came in. She's a true hack. She's beautiful. She's just got oozes class. She did a very nice workout, and I said to my co-judge when she'd done that, well, that was that's good enough. And it's always a relief when the one that you really like doesn't come out and fluff it. So that was a breathe a sigh of relief. We love the horse that was called second as well. She's just unfortunate really not to have got the place today. We were deciding between three of them. But this mare that came up to be reserved, she just grew on us from the start, and she's got beautiful limbs, and her workout was stunning, and they're both lovely, lovely horses. And one of the things I said to my co-judge was, if you were going to have a baby with one of these horses, which one would you choose? And we decided that these two mares were absolutely stunning, and you know they would stand up really, really well in the breeding. And that's what this is all about, is you know, keeping the future of these horses going.
Well, we send them off now. Out of our arena, Linden Park, Touch the Clouds, Bryony Randall, the BR Show team, the wonderful and talented Alexia Fraser, a big name in racing, doing wonderful things. Congratulations to you and DP Giselle, last year's champion, taking reserve this year. Louise Ravelo saying how fantastic to be back on the podium. Originally came across that mare through Dale Plum and Heidi Pickstock down in Cardinia, Victoria, and to be twice on the podium in 2 years is extraordinary. What a great FL Crane Perpetual Trophy for 2023 for joining us on the live stream. Great to have you here virtually, and a big thanks to the team at Prestige Racehorse Transport bringing us the broadcast box today. We'll see you back out here for the Colonel AV Pope Cup in a few moments' time.
Yeah, well done, Lindsay Douglas, and also big congratulations to Alexia Fraser, of course, the Fraser family. Mum, Joanne, they need no introduction to the show world. Of course, Father Peter, and Peter and his brothers own the